It's now is Dr. Robert Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Hey, good morning.
So mixing and matching is okay. Would you say Moderna, though, is the best way to go?
That's the way it looks. Now, this is a small study, but the results are so dramatic, it's hard to just ignore them, even though it's a small study. People that had had the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, which we know is the weakest of the three, who got boosted with Moderna, had a 76 times increase in the amount of antibody. With the Pfizer vaccine, it was about 35, and with the another Johnson & Johnson vaccine, it was about 4. Now, none of this is perfect, but there's a big difference there. And the Moderna vaccine is going to be approved, we presume, at half the dose, at 50 micrograms.
And just to be clear, mixing all of those, Pfizer, Moderna, and J&J are okay now?
Well, yeah, it's safe.
Okay.
And that's what really the FDA is all about. It's about safety. It's safe. Now, to pick the best one, you can take whichever one you want.
Gotcha.
We mentioned this quickly on Monday morning, the Delta Plus. And then I think later in the day it was talked about, it went from the UK and now there are some cases in the US. How concerned should we be about this, I guess, variant of a variant?
It's constant mutations. And so this one is called the AY42, I believe is the actual name of it. It's got two mutations associated with it. It may be 15% more transmissible, but you know, Delta has taken over, you know, the UK and most of the world actually at this particular point. This was first identified September 27th. That's not even a month ago. And it already accounts for 6%. You know, I mean, frankly, they should, until we figure out what's going on, the border really should be closed.
That seems a bit of a dramatic statement, given that Governor Pritzker is saying might not even be wearing masks by the holidays.
Well, Illinois is doing pretty good, especially Chicago and Cook County. But you get Delta Plus in here, all that's going to reverse. You're in Michigan, it's doing bad. There are states that are not doing well. It's popping up all over the place like we talked about before. So, you know, it depends really how the state is doing. I think it's a little premature to predict when the mask thing is going to go away.
All right, let's get to viewer questions. Invited to a birthday party, which will be held in a small party room at a bar. There will be 50 to 60 people in attendance. I have no idea who is or isn't vaccinated. I'm immune compromised and have gotten all vaccines. I'm 70. Would you go?
Absolutely not. This is why we're going to have a fifth wave. If this mask mandate is lifted and people go indoors in small rooms with a lot of people, some wearing masks, some not wearing masks, some vaccinated, some unvaccinated, we're going to have wave 5.
All right, this person says, my daughter is a daycare teacher for children between 1 and 2 years old. They're too little to wear masks. If there's an outbreak at the school and her little ones are exposed, what is her risk? She's vaccinated, but has a heart condition.
This is a tough call. On the good side is that in these daycare centers, there hasn't been a lot of big outbreaks. So transmitting from a little child, a small child under 5 years of age, to the adults, especially if they're wearing a mask and being careful, it hasn't been very pronounced. So there is a slight increased risk there. I'm not sure about the heart condition in this person, but this problem also is going to be resolved probably in the next 3 months, because the approval for the 6 months to 4-year-olds is likely to occur in January 2022.
All right, next question. Why are none of the COVID booster clinical trials doing antibody testing to determine a threshold at which boosters are needed?
Now, this is a very practical question. However, there's really two things going on here. One is antibody levels are just part of the immune response to determine if a vaccine is effective. There's a whole thing called the T cells that's very important. And it's too expensive to measure those. It's too difficult, so we don't measure them. So, you know, it's just one sign. The other thing is the boosters have been really approved based on clinical events. How many new infections? How many people ended up in the hospital? How many people died? The last booster was approved because with the Pfizer, after 4 months, they started seeing an increase in the number of hospitalizations. That's a hard endpoint. You know, the antibodies that we can measure now are really not that good.
All right, if you did not get your question answered, Dr. Murphy answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our Morning News Facebook page and post it there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a good weekend.
Thanks, Doctor.
Have a great weekend.
Hey, Paul.